Tell me how you feel about what?
Okay, I'm gonna marry a girl. I'm barely drinking when I'm alone. Barely ever. But I like my honey. I don't mix it. Me and the man them used to lie to ourselves that we had a special cocktail. We called it for girls. We mix a couple of stuff, like some vodka. I don't even know the names. We just mix them up. We tell the girls, yo, this one's special. You know, so when you drink them, you catch a vibe, you know. But ugly lies. Just make the wave, make we have a good time, pretty much. But yeah, I was proper drunk like 3 years ago. I went to some spot, and I don't know what happened that night, but I woke up in front of my house, pretty much. Yeah, it was kind of nasty, but my pickup lines are shit, so always on point. Nungwa boys know they lack, so.
Club this drink. Very tropical. Anyway, so Pornstar Martini was designed by Ghanaian. It has passion fruit, vodka, and then vanilla syrup, and then top up with sparkling wine. So over here, it was passion fruit puree from Munin. And then I can taste the vanilla syrup. And then I can actually taste the vodka. And it looks amazing. Really good with a nice garnish, and I think this could go for 8. This looks very watery. I don't taste a lot of the passion fruit. I taste a lot of vodka. I taste additional lemon. So there was another lemon added to it. And then I also don't take a lot of the vanilla syrup, but I can still take the sparkling wine. It's a nice drink, but it's not as amazing as the previous one. So with this, I give it 6.
We have a winner.
Okay, interviewer can promise today. I'm excited. I can't wait to see him in person. I'm a huge fan, and yes. Hi, Promise.
I've met her a couple. She's really beautiful, and yeah, she's a sweet one still. I'm not gonna lie.
Can promise.
Hi, beautiful.
Ah, thank you. You're beautiful. Good. Do you know? I know people who call you beautiful.
Call me beautiful.
Yeah. Do you know what it means to call a boy
beautiful?
I heard that
a couple of times. The girls, they just give me lines. Let it cool down.
But it's true.
What do you mean?
It's so pretty.
It's okay.
So, talking about your album, debut album.
Yeah.
How has it been so far?
It's been beautiful. It's been an amazing journey. Mm-hmm. Like, I always look forward to making my first album. And it's kind of crazy when I think about it. Like, I actually do have an album out. You know, it's not. Well, now it took me 2 years to work on it.
Wow,
yeah.
2 years.
Yeah, some of the songs on the album are like 4 years old.
Wow.
Like I'm a professionalist, so I took my time.
Mm-hmm.
And everything just came together right. So I'm grateful, you know, to have As Promised out. People are like, so cliche, why As Promised?
Yeah, like, that was my next question.
It's like, I'm like, yeah, guys, the name is Kim Promise. And the meaning behind the name is, you know, the Kim with the promise to give you good music, right? So this is good music as promised.
As promised.
Yeah, that's it. Simple.
Commando, come make a video.
You gotta do the dance when you're doing it.
Okay. Commando, come make a video.
What's your favorite song of the album? Don't give me three or four. Okay, you can give me
five. I love everything.
You know what I'm asking you is so bad because people ask me what's my favorite song of the album.
Yeah, like, you.
I didn't think which one we got picked. What? I keep telling them it keeps changing because then today is, let's say right
this
now,
one, yeah.
Right now it could be My Lady, and then when I just get into the car, then it will change to later. Then 4 hours later, it's like Commando or something.
Yeah.
Because like I treated the album like my baby because it's my first album, so it's literally my baby. Mm-hmm. Do you know what I mean? So like I treated every song like a single. It's not like one of them albums where we are like, let's make three singles, you mm-hmm. know, or four, you know, singles, and everything else be like, whatever. Nah, like every song, I wanted to be able to stand on their own, like a single, when you drop it, you know? Mm-hmm. And that's what we did. That's why it took me that long to put it together. And yeah, so that's my baby still.
And you know, all the songs, like the vibes, so, and it goes with the mood, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Like I feel like I'm your lady right now, like pretty.
Yeah,
and then the next
right
minute,
now.
I want to be like Commando. The next
minute, I
got
it. Maybe
dog.
Me for be your Commando, me go fight for you.
Aww. Yeah. So Promise has got a great style, amazing fashion sense. I'm going to ask him how he does it, if he has any inspirations, you know? And I'm going to tell him a secret of mine, because anytime I want to see what's happening in the men fashion world, if I'm not checking out any influencers and bloggers from outside the country, when it comes to Ghana, I check out Kim Promise. He's on my top 10 list. So I'm going to ask him what his inspirations are and see if he's going to share. Talking about fashion, you're an icon in Ghana, whether you like it or not.
Small. I did try small. I like to look good.
Inspiration.
Just like you do, you know.
Me? Oh, thank you. Yeah. But you are like,
I see you on Instagram doing your thing still.
Thank you.
You did. I saw your DMs, they pop still.
Oh, it's dry.
Yeah? A liar like you. It's just a vibe. Like, when I see something is nice, I just buy it, I guess. You know, just wear it. How I want to wear it.
You know, one secret. Anytime I want to know what's happening in the male fashion world, I go to your page. I'm like, yo, Thomas is just going to
yeah, man. That's what was called the first thing. Like,
he's gonna let me know what's happening.
Yeah, I was just in like Amsterdam, like last week.
Yeah.
And my boys from Daily Paper, they put me on some sweet stuff, and my shoes are like from Filling Pieces, like one of the biggest brands in Europe as well.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like different. It's not like Gucci or anybody. They're on the same level. Do you know what I mean? So like, I just like to wear, as long as it's nice.
I see
you
wearing your Gucci and Balenciaga.
Yeah, once in a while, we put that one to front side.
What size do you wear those sneakers at? Not because I want to get you a gift, no.
Why not? My birthday is actually next week. You might as well.
I hate you. How did you feel when the list of Africans on Beyonce's album came out? Like, because I feel like you could have been on there.
No, I felt super excited. Like, it's a good time and a great time to be African right now. Because Afrobeat is like taking over right now. Like back in the day, when you were met, like anyone meets you and you're from Africa, you're like, oh, which country? You say Ghana, like, oh, Michael Essien.
Oh,
Didier Drogba.
Yeah.
But now it's like, oh, Wizkid.
Yeah.
Oh, Kim Promise. Oh, Mr. Easy. Do you know what I mean? So like the music is actually, you know, representing us right now. It's only, you know, up to us to take it and run with it, because it's the momentum is building and we just have to take hold of it. Like, so many big things have happened. Like, I played some of the biggest festivals in the world this year.
Yes.
It's crazy for me. Like,
Afro Nation, Portugal.
Yeah, I did Portugal. I just came back like 2 days ago.
Wow.
Yeah, and then I did like Oh My Festival in Amsterdam. Mm-hmm. It was one of the biggest festivals in Europe. And, you know, a couple others.
And you were on Patty in the Park as well?
Yeah, I did that as well. And yeah, a few other ones. It's amazing. Like, it's a blessing to be here right now. To
tell
be African
me the feeling.
Right
how does it feel like? Because I saw a video of you from Patty in Afro Nation, Portugal, and the girls were all over you.
Yeah, the music will go for the girls now.
Jeez.
Because when you go out there, I always say this, like, you don't expect the guys to come and stand in front of you and sing it. I want to be selfish with you. No, the girls do that. But there's music for the man as well. But yeah, like, it's a vibe. Like, when you just go out there and people sing your songs, like, word for word, and you're not even in your home country, you know?
Mm-hmm.
You're abroad, and people just can, like, sing everything and just catch a vibe. Because me, when I'm on stage, it's a party. Like, I just, I like to have a good time.
Mm-hmm.
And just all that stuff is just, for me, it's just humbling and also beautiful, like, just to know that I'm doing something good and, you know, it's actually catching on and people are loving it. And the fact that I get to represent my people, you know, I'm like an ambassador of Ghana when I go out there.
Yeah, true.
I'm always saying, like, Ghana, Ghana, Ghana.
True.
Yeah, because I believe we have something beautiful out here. Like,
I'm going to spell a word, then you pronounce it. Sorry, I have to put you on the, like, on the spot.
Yeah, it's all right. Let's see. Hopefully my degree works with that.
Yeah, so it's Ibiza, pronounce it.
Ibiza.
Yeah.
Ibiza.
Ibiza.
But they say Ibiza.
Yeah, Ibiza.
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 Yeah.
Okay. That's like the UK guys.
Yeah.
Ibiza.
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 Yeah. Yeah. But Ghana, we'll say Ibiza.
I know, right? Ibiza. Yeah. Okay, you got it right.
Yeah.
Thank you, Kim Promise.
Thanks for
AKA
having me.
AKA Greg.
Yeah. Don't know. Your boy Kim Promise. One love. Shouts to you guys.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, one love. And, you know, keep supporting, keep watching. Boom.
I think Promise is an amazing person. He's down to earth. That is one thing for sure. Super down to earth. He listens. And yeah, he has this cool vibe, you know. Yeah, he has a cool vibe. And I like it. Pornstar Martini. Sexy name, sexy drink. So I'm sipping this drink and like my head is heavy, my eyes are like heavy and I'm trying so hard to open my eyes. I just hope I don't overdo it and give myself away. And I'm here like, gosh, I need to stop drinking. No, I can't stop. I need to stop. I can't stop. Now look at me, look at my life.